It is our weekly update involving Jackrabbit Soccer from GoJacks.com. Heavily anticipated because it's double the pleasure, double the fun to start things off before we talk with Brock Thompson. We have the Murdzeks with us. One of them is Avery. One of them is Laney. It would be a mystery, except right now on the screen we're saying which one is which, so that kind of gives it away. All right, so Avery, raise your hand. Laney, raise your hand. Okay. Avery, let's begin with this. How did you end up at South Dakota State?
I ended up at South Dakota State because I went to a lot of ID camps and I played a lot of games where I got scouted, and I went to an ID camp and I loved the culture and the positivity from all the players that are previously here. And it was just the first ID camp that I liked everyone who was on the team, who was very welcoming and nice to me.
Laney, you're nodding in agreement with that. Now I'm curious, how much talk was there of, did you two want to go to the same school? Did you make your own decisions? How did this come together?
We did. We always planned on going to the same school. We've always wanted to play soccer together and continue to play soccer together.
So I'm going to ask you, what's the best part of being a twin?
The best part of being a twin is having a built-in best friend.
All right, so Avery, what's the worst part of being a twin?
Worst part about being a twin would probably be that people think we're the same person, but we're not.
I like that. That's a very good answer. This past weekend, playing at home. Laney, I'll start with you. Just the experience, the way you guys played, was a very good weekend to build upon what you're trying to accomplish.
Yes, it was so much fun to finally be able to play back at our home game, and it was really fun with all the fans that showed up and cheer us on every day. It was a really fun experience.
And as you're getting into this now, Avery, I want to get your opinion as well. Just the team, the cohesiveness, explain how important that's been.
I think as we've gone on throughout the year, we've been able to play more as a team, and we've grown a lot from the first game to this game. And it's just been really fun to watch us grow too, and like also me personally, because like I've learned so much new stuff here. And then watching film, like watching me grow on film has just been fun, and our team.
And on this, how do you motivate her, and how does she motivate you?
I feel like I'm always cheering her on, like on the sideline. Like
she is.
I think I'm probably her biggest fan and supporter.
Hey, how about you, Laney?
I agree. She is my biggest fan, and I'd like to think that I'm your biggest fan too.
Thanks.
Head coach Brock Thompson with us. We'll get into the performance from this past weekend in a moment, but Jackrabbit Soccer, a family affair. We've talked about it in the past. The Mandings, among others. You've had sisters before. You got twins now in the Murdzeks we just talked about. It's an important part of this program.
For sure. It's a really neat part of our program, and to have two sets of sisters and a set of twins on the team is it's just a different experience. But I think, as they alluded to, our team is just really connected. And in their connection that they bring to each other, it also kind of reaches out to their other teammates as well.
This past weekend at Fishback, two victories, and not just two wins, but scoring 10 goals in the two wins was rather impressive.
Yeah, we've known very early in the season that attacking-wise, it's one of the more talented attacking teams that we've had. And that piece is very, very exciting. And I think you're starting to see as we get into the season some of the things that we're capable of in front of goal and in the final third. And we've scored some great goals up until this point. And really, it's a result of having very dangerous, explosive players and a lot of depth in the final third.
Well, and certainly both the Murdzeks are explosive players. I feel bad lumping them together because I'm sure they get sick of that being twin sisters. But four goals, two assists combined between them in the two victories.
Yeah, and what a weekend, right? What a weekend for them. What a start to their freshman year. They're both able to create opportunities for themselves and others. They're both able to score goals and set up goals. But it's really more they can do so much more than just create and score goals too. They're good playmakers. They're good soccer players. They're really committed to becoming the best version of themselves they can. They get an extra training. There's so many things that they're doing right now at a young age that just makes the future very exciting for them and exciting for us.
I know the Creighton game is just one game and stuff happens, but still, to bounce back as you did this weekend, a big positive.
Yeah, we talked a lot heading into Northern Iowa about how we respond, and champions respond to things, and average people and teams just tend to react. And I felt like the response we had Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday in training was Very, very good. It was really exactly what we needed as far as just a mindset to prepare. And then we went down 1-0 against Northern Iowa, and the response within the game was very good too. And to come back and score a goal fairly quickly after we went down 1-0 and then to head into the locker room up 2-1, I'm just really proud of how our team really committed to responding like a champion this week and throughout the Northern Iowa game as well.
All right, finishing touches on non-conference play coming up this week with one home, one away. Let's start with Friday and Northern Illinois coming to Brookings.
Yeah, you know, it's a team we haven't played for a few years. Harder team to scout because they'll do some different things on film. And so, you know, from a team standpoint, it's a positive thing because we always talk about having to expect the unexpected a little bit. And they will change a little. They're a little bit like Northern Iowa. They'll change how they play based on their opponent, maybe a little bit more than most. And so we just have to be prepared to play how we want to play from that. Very difficult weekend overall when you talk about, you know, playing at home and then traveling to Colorado Springs in altitude and playing the Air Force Academy and having to manage that. And it should be a good final weekend of non-conference play to prepare us for the Summit League in that season. And the Summit League is probably having the best women's soccer year on record. And so we've got to take another step forward this weekend as a team, so we're prepared for October.